Red 6 is an augmented reality platform company. We build solutions that enable things that are impossible using augmented reality.
We're currently focused on our shortest term goals, which are getting our solutions into fighter pilot cockpits, basically enabling the fighter pilots to be able to see entities that don't exist and fight and train against them.
Every time a fighter pilot goes up to fly and train, they need someone to fly and train against, and that's a multi-billion dollar a year problem. We don't have the airplanes, we don't have the money, we don't have the pilots, and even if we did, we're not capable of simulating modern near-peer threats.
And then you add in any of the actual risk factors or the human lives into it, and it becomes a math problem that doesn't look so great for you.
What we've done with the augmented reality is seek to replace the need to put the adversary aircraft and all of the associated costs up in the sky. We can do that through augmented reality and using Unreal to simulate any threat we want in the world. And that's a tremendously exciting value proposition.
We've talked to a number of different pilots about this, both Air Force and Navy and many others. They're curious but skeptical because they think, how's this going to work? Because they've used head-up displays for multiple decades now, but are extremely narrow, one color, sometimes only one eye.
We're asking the technology to do a lot of things. First, we need to track and understand what the airplane's doing, and what the pilot's head is, and what the pilot is looking at in the most dynamic environments. 300 to 400 miles an hour, pulling 9 Gs, doing aerobatics. We need to then draw really quickly to a display technology that's capable of working outdoors in bright environments across a network. And we're saying, oh, by the way, we need to do that sub 20 milliseconds for it to be training value. So there's a massive amount of technical hurdles that we've had to overcome, but I'm delighted to say that we've done it, and it is working spectacularly well. And the Unreal Engine has been a huge part of that.
Doing augmented reality correctly requires extremely low latency.
When you're on the ground and you're doing something in augmented reality, there's kind of an almost like fudged error that doesn't exist in the air. So now we're doing 300 miles an hour plus, and any of those discrepancies or deviations show themselves in quarter mile distances.
So anything that you can do to shrink this latency stack has a massive impact on the realism and therefore the training value. Did we start with Unreal Engine? No, we didn't. But we moved to it as soon as we could.
We saw about a third of the original latency that we had from our previous solution. After that, it was no questions asked. This is how we're going to build this tool.
The biggest challenge we're trying to display synthetic assets is tracking. Without tracking, it doesn't matter how good your augmented reality display is, because it's going to be dancing all over the place.
They can go up, down, left, right, do barrel rolls, do backflips, whatever. So how do you figure out where that head is now? Not necessarily where the aircraft is, but where is that pilot or where is that co-pilot looking?
So we had to invent a totally new method of tracking, that we track the head in relative terms and we track the aircraft in absolute terms. You put those two together, you bind a camera to it in UE4, and you have a 300 miles per hour augmented reality solution that you can use, and that's exactly what we built.
The reactions we've been getting from pilots, they've just been incredible.
The first time you're up in a real airplane and you look out of the window and there's a big old airplane flying around in the sky that doesn't actually exist, and the penny drops in that they start to understand the real training value.
They get out and they go, where the heck has this been? We want it now. Why can't this be in my cockpit tomorrow?
Red 6 today is a video game in the sky, focused on the Department of Defense. But looking beyond that, that's where the real excitement comes from, because we're building the future in all fields, military and civilian.